Alright, how to make masks in a Blender? If you came to Blender from 3ds Max or others like me, you have noticed that we don't have same render elements where we can choose object ID mask as we used in V-Ray or Corona, which allowed us to get color mask automatically. But we still can do this in Blender just using another way. So let's talk about how to make the same of this color mask in Blender. Masks are significantly short, and if you are used to getting colored mask like object ID in V-Ray or Corona render, the Blender doesn't allow us to get the same colored mask simply by adding them as render elements. Especially for me, the importance of masks is beyond words, because I always build my work process in such a way that everything can be completed in post-production in Photoshop. I will do in Photoshop, then spend a lot of time to achieve the same result on a render. And when you are used to working in 3ds Max and getting such mask automatically, or your customer asks you to provide him with the color mask for further work, in the Blender you will either have to look for an add-on or make a flat render like Workbench with flat light and random colors. So I found an excellent way to work with mask and make them for Photoshop with a Blender, and I do not need any add-ons or even additional render. Everything will be ready from the main render and have a couple of clicks. In general, what is the easiest way to do this? Turn on Workbench as a render engine and choose flat light and random color, and you get a flat and color render of all objects. You remove gamma so that the colors are a little saturated, or you go to the Blender market and look for an add-on. I don't like any of these options. First of all, it's necessary to make an additional render, and when your scene is heavy, even in this mode, it may not be convenient. Secondly, I never understood and used such colored mask, because if you have a complex scene where a bunch of objects, or you have a forest, then select the leaves having such masks. That may be a hard task. You will pick tiny objects until select everything you need. I want to click once and select everything. Fortunately, there is a such way, and it's available in Blender without installing additional add-ons. And that's CryptoMate. CryptoMate is open source software better known for CGI compositors, where CryptoMate is quite popular and used in every project. And its popularity is quite deserved because it allows you to make masks based on the mate ID of each object in the scene or material. CryptoMate itself looks like this. This is multicolored render on which nothing is clear, and what to do with this is not clear. But I will show you all the advantages now. First, we need to go to Layer Properties and turn on CryptoMate. This allows you to quickly get masks on all your objects. Turn on Object to have masks based on each object in the scene. If you need Material ID, then also turn on Material as well. You can also enable Asset if you need to make a mask according to your assets. In this case, each of the assets that you choose in a set will have a mask. It's appropriate if you need to immediately select all the elements of one asset and have one mask. I usually choose object and materials. That's all, but let's look at this deeply, because CryptoMate is so complex render elements and we have a lot of way to use it. Let's go to Compositing tab, and here we see that new layers have been added to our render. CryptoMate objects, CryptoObject 00, 01, 02, The object is responsible for object materials for materials. If we connect it to our view node, no information here now. So we need to make a render to get this information. It's done. Render here and I'll connect CryptoMate to viewer. This CryptoMate image are in general very colorful, assigned each object or material different random color. The program create mates that support motion blur, transparency and depth of field using data that is already available at render time. CryptoMate consists a lot of information and this information must be extracted. For this, Blender has a node that allows us to do this. Press Shift A, type CryptoMate, and here our node, which help us to extract information from CryptoMate. If you're working with CryptoMate in the same scene where you made render, you choose render here. If you're working in the new Blender scene, then choose image and find your file with CryptoMate. Then you can select the required CryptoMate object or material. Depending on what you need and all that remains is just pick on your render to extract the necessary object and isolate objects that can already be used as a mask. By the way, it works with motion blur, transparency and depth of field. And even if this object is overlapped by another object, then you can select this object with one click. And this is one of the advantages of why I advise using CryptoMate. Because you just pick an object and make a mask out of them. Then you can add the color balance node or something else. And using CryptoMate node where there is already information about our visible object, add mate as a mask and adjust the color brightness, make another adjustment. The main principle is to add a CryptoMate node, choose an object and use it as a mask. Easy! Of course, using compositing in a Blender in the same scene where you make art can be quite a serious task for your computer. So, at this stage, I advise you to simply save all render elements into EXR format and then work with it in a new Blender file or immediately open EXR in Photoshop using EXR.io. It's free Photoshop plugin that allows you to not only open EXR but also CryptoMate masks. So, for example, I'll open the file output node. In the properties, I choose the file format Open EXR Multilayer and add input to all of my render elements. Click the render and get the finished EXR. Next, let's try to open this EXR in Photoshop and I will show you why you should not do this, but rather make the necessary mask in a Blender compositing. Open Photoshop and select the file. Here we choose CryptoMate mask and press open. Since CryptoMate consists a lot of information about all the render objects, Photoshop opens each of these objects as a separate layers. That's what we get. Photoshop asks us if we really wanna open all 5000 CryptoMate layers. Of course not. It's madness. Also, sometimes XR.io can't open CryptoMate at all, or doesn't open correctly. Sometimes it happens. In one of my projects, I couldn't open CryptoMate in Photoshop at all. So, I'll open a Blender to make masks and then I'll go to Photoshop with them. In the Blender, I choose the image node and open my EXR. As we see, all my render elements were restored as they should. As we saw, CryptoMate has information about more than 5000 render objects, but I don't need as many masks. In general, I understood what I will do in post-production and keep only those masks that I need. If I will need something else, I can always return to the blender and create the necessary mask additionally. If you prefer working only in a blender, then you can simply use the same CryptoMate to work further in a blender. But if you need to export the necessary mask to Photoshop, you can do it like this. I add three mix nodes with one black and second red, blue and green colors that correspond to RGB channels. Of course, you can use different colors, but I advise RGB and I will explain why. Using these nodes and CryptoMate, I will make colored mask. I want to add some sun rays among these trees. So I need a mask on this gate and this tree. I choose the gate in CryptoMate, then mix the node with red color. Connect mate as a mask and get a red mask on the gate. Next, the same for this tree. Again in CryptoMate, choose a tree and blue mix node. Also, I can combine different objects into one mask, just pick all the necessary objects, just it's important that they are not crossed with the nearest objects. For instance, pick this object, this and this. Repeat for another color mask, so you feel all random. And next I will combine all these mix nodes and that's what I have. RGB masks for all important elements on my render. Save the image with mask and go to Photoshop. So we are in Photoshop and let's take a look at why I advise using RGB mask. I bet that usually you are used to select elements, just pick them in Photoshop. But I just select a layer with a mask and go to channels. So I want to select elements that have a blue color mask. In the channel I turn on only the blue channel and see that all blue elements turn into white. I just press Ctrl and pick this channel. See it? All blue channel was selected as a mask. Go to layers and I have selected it. Then you may work with this mask as usually use mask in Photoshop. Same with other channels. It's an absolutely easy way to select render elements. You do not need to choose a mask every time trying to hit the eyedropper tool on same object. Just go to the channel on the proper layer and make a selection. It's convenient. So I wanna add some sun rays among these trees. I have Atmos ray brushes. Maybe this one would be great. Yes. I painted rays and now I need to remove all this part like the gate and trees. Once more I selected layer mask and go to the channel. My gate is a blue channel. I selected the blue channel and remove the gate from this layer through the mask layer. The same I do with the red channel and trees. As you can see, I had only a couple of clicks and achieved the result. I also had an idea to draw light effect on this woman. Since I used photos of people in this art instead of 3D models, because it's a free way to use people in your art, I want to overpaint the light to separate this woman from the background. By the way, write in the comments if you are interested to find out three ways to use realistic people in your art. Maybe we will talk about it in the next time. So, I wanna paint the light on her dress and umbrella. Add a new layer where I will paint the light. Select her by mask and add a mask layer to my new layer. Now I can paint light within the mask selection. We got an object ID mask in a blender using CryptoMate and mix node with red, blue and green colors without any add-ons. This way is absolutely easy to use and almost automatically allows to create and support motion, blur, transparency and depth of field. Of course, this method will take a little time, but you can prepare a mask closer to your goals. Quite often we do not need a lot of masks. You know what you will correct and make masks only for these objects. If it's necessary, you can always go back to XR with CryptoMate and make new mask, and do not even need to make a render. So write in the comment what method you use, whether you find CryptoMate convenient for work with mask. Also, if you have questions, write in the comments or add to my Discord and Patreon. See you in the next video. Bye.